Hey, it's Ty, the real estate guy, and today I'm going to talk to you about using the Home Builder's Preferred Lender. I'm going to answer the question, are they really a great deal, or are they ripping you off? There are a lot of you out there looking to build a home. If you don't know this now, you'll find out quickly when you start visiting model homes that most builders will offer you a better deal for using their preferred lender. The incentive is often money towards closing costs or any number of upgrades. This often leaves buyers wondering, where's this incentive money coming from? Rightfully so, many assume that in some way they are paying for it, either with increased closing costs or a higher mortgage rate. Just so you all know, I have helped hundreds of families through the process of building a home, and I've worked with dozens of these preferred lenders. So I'm speaking from personal experience when I say the incentive to use a preferred lender makes it hard for outside lenders to compete. Your closing cost or mortgage rate could possibly be slightly higher with a preferred lender, but with the builder's incentive, you're usually better off going with the builder's lender, but not always. Despite what many think, most of the builder's preferred lenders are not out there to take advantage of you, but you'd be a fool not to get a second quote from an outside lender just to make sure. I also want to take a moment to clarify something. There are basically two types of preferred lenders. There are the lenders who aren't tied to the builder financially in any way. They've just done a great job for the builder, and the builder knows they can trust them to take care of their clients. The second type of preferred lender is the lender that is owned by the builder, or they're tied together financially in some way. This is usually how the large national builders operate. I also always hear people say things like, I have to use a preferred lender. Please understand that the builder can't force you to use their lender, but legally and ethically, the builder can choose to only offer the incentive to those who use their lender. You're probably asking, how can the builder's lender give me a better deal? Well, most preferred lenders will take a reduced commission because the builder is just giving them the business. It's also common for the builder to contribute cash to incentivize the buyers to use their lender. You should know that the home builders want to make sure the preferred lenders are giving you a fair deal, and if the builder believes their preferred lender is taking advantage of you, their clients, they will replace them with a lender that will be more competitive. So, what's in it for the builder? First of all, they'll know right away if the buyer isn't going to qualify, and they can cancel that buyer and move on. I have seen outside lenders give loan approvals to a buyer, then the builder builds them a home only to find out that the buyer could never qualify to buy that home. The builder now has a major problem. They have a completed home with someone else's selections, and this completed home is costing them money every day that it sits there. If the home takes a few months to sell, it will end up costing the builder thousands of additional dollars. The other advantage to the builder is that they know that the buyer will be ready to close on time because a preferred lender is always up to date with the often changing closing date. The other argument is that it's going to be easier for you to use a preferred lender. That is usually true as well because the preferred lender is in constant contact, often attending weekly meetings with the builder to see how all the buyers are doing and confirming that the homes are scheduled to close on time. An outside lender doesn't have this information, so they're often not able to close on time. Some outside lenders do just fine, and sometimes outside lenders can beat the deal the builder's offering you, but for the most part, it's going to save you money and time to use a preferred lender because they've streamlined this process. Really, for the most part, you are better off to go with the builder's preferred lender. Just remember to get a second quote from an outside lender to confirm you're getting the best deal. It never hurts to make the builder's lender compete. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to message me below. If you're looking to build a home and you live in Utah, please give me a call. Lending is just a small part of the home building process. If you're serious about building a home, you'll want to check out my video, 10 things you should know before you build a home. I'll put the link to this below. Thanks for watching my video. If you found this information helpful, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more great real estate videos. Thank you.